Hello everybody, it's Nim and welcome back to the speed build. It's been a while since we've done a speed build, and this is not just a speed build, this is a very special speed build. This is a tiny zoo that I am making for a contest, which I'm probably not gonna win, but that doesn't matter. Although in the beginning I really wanted to win, but you know, in the end I really enjoyed the process more than I would winning. Which sounds really like I'm trying to be a good loser, and I'm not a good loser in any sort of way. But building this zoo, it's just been so much fun because you are restricted to a border. So the border is like the weird stone thing which will be obviously removed at the end of the zoo. And it's a 50 by 50 zoo. And I actually really enjoyed making it. So let me talk you through the ideas that I have of this zoo. So my initial plan was to build this either very futuristic modern zoo or this extremely overrun forgotten zoo, and then I realized, you know, a lot of people are probably gonna do that because it is very obvious when you're thinking outside of the box. I mean, it had to be like a zoo which would be special, and a lot of people go, ooh, a complete overrun deserted zoo, or oh, something very futuristic and alien-like. Those are like the immediate things that you go through. Or go to, at least in my mind, I went there. And I imagined more people would do that, so I came up with the idea to build a little Italian town zoo. So, the idea here is that there is this little town somewhere in Italy, hidden in the mountains, and the only way to get there is actually by boat. So the entrance will be a ferry, which came with the new Europe Pack, which I absolutely love. And surrounding the town would be like a lot of mountains and some orchards, but then for wine, so I'm not really sure what you call them. In Dutch was called wijngaard. I can't remember the English name for that. Yikes. So basically fields full of grapes and everything where you can make wine of. Whatever, right? And the idea is that not a lot of people were coming to this town, so you know, the town needed to think of something to get like tourists there. So what did they do? They were like, you know what? What if we rebuild this entire town to also be a zoo? So there are a lot of animals in here actually. For the contest you only needed, I think, 3 habitats. Yeah, we have some more. I think we ended up with 7 different animals because we... Let's cross them off, okay? We have hippos, which are obviously very Italian animals. That's probably the only animal which is not native to Europe, but I had to have a hippo there. We have peafowls, we have flamingos, badgers, deers, the weird ibex mountain goat thingies, and the lynx. So those are gonna be, you know, living in the zoo. It's gonna be a zoo with 0 barriers, so the animals are free to roam wherever. Which took me a while to figure that out, by the way. And apparently there's just a setting which makes animals don't leave their natural habitat. I didn't realize that, but there is, so yeah. And another fun thing of this actual contest is that you aren't allowed to build outside the 50 by 50 border. Obviously scenery is excluded from that, which thank goodness, right? But that had to mean that all the buildings, I couldn't build like buildings outside of the 50 by 50, so I couldn't incorporate it into an entire town because I wasn't allowed to build behind the border. So what I'm doing here is like deleting all the trees that were native to the area because, you know, I didn't want them because I was gonna give it my own little twist. And I thought I cut it out, but apparently I didn't. So what we're gonna do with the outside, we are going to build a lot, or build, place a lot of trees down there. And I chose for the taiga biome, obviously because I chose the taiga map, but then also mixing with the temperate, just because the temperate plants and temperate rocks are very common in Italy. And I wanted to give this really good mix for it. And up to this point, I had 0 clue what I wanted to. I was like, you know what? Let's just finish this border first. And then I saw this grape field, so I was like, ooh, a winery, yes. So I started, you know, what you see in every orchard. It is an orchard, right? I don't know. Like this big rows of dirt where the actual plants are going to be placed in there. Now, bear in mind, these are really big. And in the end, we're gonna change it a little bit because I'm not building an orchard like that wide. That'd be kind of ridiculous. And here we are building with one of the mesh fences. Now, I wasn't quite sure if this was allowed because actually you weren't supposed to put any cedary except from plants down. And I was like, well, you know what? It actually looks pretty good. And here I was like, oh yeah, I'm going to copy all this over already, but I forgot to put the grapes on there. So I'm gonna redo this because obviously I forgot to do that. So, you know, learn from my mistakes, finish it before you place it. And actually these grapes came with a Europe pack as well. I love the Europe pack, and that's not just because I'm European myself and I recognize a lot of these things, but actually the amount of nature that they bring with them is really good. And also the animals, you know, they're quite common animals for me. I can see them wherever I walk in the Netherlands. But I actually really like it, and I feel like it's very normal for me. But perhaps African people have that with the Africa pack. They're like, oh yeah, well, a lion. I can go outside and see lions, but for me it's really special. So I heard a lot of people saying like, oh, the Europe pack, and it doesn't have any special animals. Well, you know, maybe for people native in Europe, no, but I think Asian people might be very surprised about the badger. You know, just for example. So here we are finishing the rest of the outside of the zoo, because I felt like before I could even start working on the inside, I need to be sure that the outside is perfect. Otherwise, you're going to do really weird and corporate things. And, you know, it's going to add up in the end. You can also see that I already filled in some of the zones in the zoo. So, all in Dutch, because, you know, I am Dutch and I just wanted to spell easily. Because in English, I can't always spell. It's just that my mind doesn't do the English words. You know, with whatever. And I thought, you know, in Dutch, it was actually a bit simpler for me. Also, this plant, love it, and this tall tree, I don't remember the tree, I think it's a cypress tree, I'm not quite sure. I really love it, and obviously I went to Rome, when was it? 2019? Yeah, it was the year before COVID happened, it was my last big trip. I went to Rome because I graduated, and they have a lot of these trees, like these trees are everywhere. So I saw this tree and I was like, yep, that's Italian. Hell yes. You know, we're just placing some trees and making it look, you know, properly. And I know that from a distance you can't even see the dirt, but you know, it's for your own imagination and your own immersion that actually, you know, it looks pretty darn well, if I may say so. Also, I still have the COVID, so my throat is a little bit sore. So I'm just gonna excuse myself and drink some water right now. Much better. Anyways, you know, this rock work as well, I feel like it finishes up the entire landscape. Otherwise it would be a little bit boring to look at. But now you have like these rocks and you rotate them slightly, so just every rock that you see is just a little bit different, and it makes it really nice. There you can see, you know, our surroundings are pretty much complete. We also already have a track train or a ride going through there, which is the train. And we've built a giant waterfall, which I did not incorporate here, just for the bare effect that I forgot to record that. Otherwise, you would have seen it. And now we're gonna start in the entrance. Now, since this is like a town, I wanted the entrance to feel like sort of a little plaza, really. And I wanted it to feel really natural, and I feel like I succeeded in that. And like these houses right now, they don't look that good. You know, but once it is all finished, it's better. I feel like that's happened a lot with Planet Zoo. Whenever you really build it or starting to build something, I'm just like, yikes, this is not gonna look good. This is gonna be awful. And then in the end, it looks actually pretty, you know, half decent. So quite happy with that. And, you know, it was a little bit figuring out what looked really Italian or what didn't. But in the end, you know, I'm really happy that it worked out the way that it did. And I feel like this house is really Italian. It doesn't look Italian right now, but, you know, stone and everything. I actually went back and looked for some pictures of Rome when I was there. Like, you know, what kind of stone do the houses have? And it's actually a house that had, like, these types of stones. I was like, well, you know, that's actually really nice. It looks quite good. Also, I can hear the strain on my voice right now because it's been a while since I've done a voiceover. And then the fact that, you know, I'm not completely the full 100% here. It is kind of annoying, but, you know, whatever. Plus, it is actually a very long voiceover. And I could stand here and, you know, talk, and I'm not quite sure if people enjoy me talking for like half an hour, but whatever. I don't really care. But I don't feel like I'm gonna last the full half hour with my voice right now. So we're just gonna see how far I can manage. And if it's, you know, if my voice is done, we're just gonna stop and I'm gonna, you know, surrender you guys to basic music. I'm gonna do my best to find some Italian music because I feel like that's actually really nice. Oh yes, and these planters. I love these planters. I should have used them more throughout the entire zoo. But they're so cute. I mean, with all the different types of plants in there as well, I feel like it looks really nice. And actually it was quite difficult to place the plants in there perfectly. Because sometimes, you know, it would just stick out. That'd be a little bit weird. Also, why doesn't the planter downstairs have any plants in there? Just noticed that. Yikes. Forgot to do that. So down here, I believe we had a Loony Balloons, if I'm correct. Yes, Loony Balloons. And I wanted to feel this, you know, make these shops feel all very incorporated, like their houses. And these people just decided, you know what, we're gonna need some touristy, so we're gonna open a shop in them as well. You know, something like that, like those real old-fashioned family shops. I wanted to go for that idea, and I feel like with these shops, it actually went pretty well. Obviously, you know, adding the plank there, so you can put your money on there and the counter. That's really realistic. And, you know, I want to go for some signs to show you how much money the balloons actually were, so we go for the classic ones. Fun fact, you can't actually put a euro sign on the signs. It all goes in dollars, which, you know, I actually feel like is pretty annoying because I want euros in my zoo, but you can't, so it is what it is, and you're just gonna have to deal with it. So here we are building a second building, and this building... Oops, wow, okay, I don't know why I did that. This building actually is gonna have two buildings. The orange one and then the yellow one here, and they're going to be incorporated next to each other, you know, just like part of the orchery. Is it an orchery? I don't remember what the word is. Let me just Google translate this while it is going on. Translate a vineyard. Oh, a vineyard. Okay, well. I didn't realize translation would be that easy. I thought it was like a very difficult word, but okay, whatever. It's a vineyard. I can live with that. That's completely fine. Whatever. So let's see where we were with this build. Ah, yes, we just did the roof and now we need to finish up these little thingies. And I actually quite like the color combination. At first I was a little bit unsure because we just had a stone building. And now working on plaster. But it's actually quite common in Rome, at least, and what I saw on Google, for the Italian homes to have like very, very colorful homes. And I was like, you know what? Yellow and orange, that is about as colorful as you can get. And obviously, there are later on some more shops with more extravagant colors. Don't you worry about that. I mean, it is like a very fancy zoo. Yeah, here I still had the idea of making this like into a bit of a facade at just some homes. And then in a few minutes I'm gonna realize, actually I want it to be a wine shop because we have like the vineyard there. Apparently that's the word. And so we should incorporate that in this build. So, you know, we're gonna just sell wine here, which is completely fine. I mean, I love wine myself, so... you won't see me saying no to a bottle of wine or a glass of wine. I'm just mesmerized by placing these big windows. There are so much windows. Like, imagine the inner walls would be insane by this many windows. It's just, wow. Yeah, and we had like this European fence that we placed, and then up here, I wanted to be like a picnic bench there, so you can buy something in the shop downstairs and then sit on top. And I actually think I did a really good job at making sure that the road isn't visible. and having like a real stair stare. I actually feel like that's incorporated really nice, and I quite like that the way that it is. Ah yes, and the planter, which obviously we're gonna place, and we're gonna place a really big tree in there. I feel like I probably use that tree more often in the zoo, because this tree is just amazing. And it looks so good. And then, you know, some more of those cypress trees. I'm gonna call them cypress trees, because I'm not exactly sure, but I think that's what they're called. And there we are, placing the vine ranks on top of this house. Just making sure, you know, the vine doesn't only grow in the orchard there or in the yard there. It also grows on this house. And that's where they, you know, pick the grapes and make wine for it for their own shop. So I felt like this was actually pretty cool. Especially the fact since that Planet Zoo already has like these ranks which are filled with grapes, and they have like empty ones, so you can add in your own grapes, and they have white and red grapes mixed, and I actually feel like it's so cool. I really like the way that it looks. Sometimes they're a bit difficult to place, especially these ones, because you want it to be playful and not a lot of the exact same spots or the same height. But I actually like it, and of course wine in Italian is vino, so we're selling vino with this beautiful sign. And I thought of adding an arrow to this sign. Let me know what you guys think of that. But I thought it was just yikes. I thought it was way too big. It needed to be a shorter arrow, but they didn't have one, so you know. And then I realized, wait, I actually want a real shop. Not like of make-believe, but an actual shop. So I think we placed the smoothie one here. And then we had to make sure that the path was correct, which was actually kind of difficult because, you know, the path in general in Planet Zoo is difficult. I don't have to say anything about that. We all know the path is annoying. Planet Zoo is probably never going to fix that, and that's completely fine as well. Like, it doesn't really, I mean, it bothers me, but, you know, I can live with it. I'm getting better at the path system every day, and I think this zoo proved that I'm actually exceptionally good with the path system. Also on the floor you can see like this little custom curb that I tried. Afterwards I just realized you could do curbs in the settings and you didn't have to do it custom, which then I obviously took advantage of because that's way easier. So here we are building this little information shop. And I feel like I've put in two information points here where you can buy like tours and tickets and all the other stuff. And I really like the way it ended up. I feel like it's really homesy and comfy. Yeah, you can't, unfortunately you can't place that end there, so. To do that with custom things. I'm placing some roof trims, you know, just making it look a little bit more finished. I feel you can call it like that. And this home is actually one of my favorite little homes. It is like really tiny. And then you have like this really big door there. I'm just like, okay, well, there's this door and then the windows. I feel like it really... I can believe this is an actual home. And obviously I have played a lot of The Sims. So I know window placements. Yeah, I think my roots started with The Sims. Perhaps I should play The Sims 4 again. Oh well. Yeah, so here we are placing this information stand, you know, obviously with the planks again, so you can put your money on them. First of all, you know, it's, I don't like getting so close to people. I didn't like getting close to people before the pandemic started. And now it is an extremely good reason not to get close to people. No, ironically, I got COVID at my job where I work with children, so you have to like stay close to them, so I'm not gonna say anything about that, but, you know. Also, yeah, this is just me browsing out the entire section because I was looking for something and then I didn't remember what I was looking for, but I think I was looking for some edible signs, or editable signs, not edible, that's like eating, but editable, as in you can edit the sign. And I was just to buy tickets there. And I quite like it. I mean, with a green... I'm doing it with my hands because I can't find a word, like the The thing you stand on though when it's raining. I really don't have words today. I plan to do more voiceovers today, but I don't think I'm gonna do that. I don't think that's such a good idea. Also, you know, obviously with a wine again. Because, you know, it is like a wine village, so you're gonna have wine everywhere. And at this point, you know, it didn't look that good. Like, let's be honest, it needed something more, so we're gonna play some nature, we're gonna play some rocks as well. And I've always said that, like, when people are like, wow, how do you build that? How do you make something look so good? It's very simple. It is all in your rock work and nature. Like, landscaping and rock work is one of the major things that actually, it tells your zoo. It sets your zoo apart, that's what I should say. If you don't have a good nature, if you don't have good scenery, you can make the most beautiful habitat, the most amazing buildings, but if you don't incorporate it with the nature around it, it's gonna look pretty awful. Again, my opinion, don't judge me for it. So I wanted this really big eye catcher, so I decided to make like this really big fountain. You know, and it doesn't look big now, but just wait for it, because we're going to put an elephant on there. Not that we have elephants in this zoo, but it was the only statue I could find that was tiny. So, yep. Perhaps I should have used elephants instead of hippos, oh well. And, you know, we're going to use a lot of the water tricks here. I would call them tricks, like the water thingies. No, just to make it look like it's actually very nice. Zoo and a nice feature. And I believe we actually are gonna change some of this, because I thought I was gonna make it look like the water was coming out of his trunk, but I'm not sure now. I mean, that's what I think I did, but how can one be sure, because it's been a while since I've built this. Oh, right, I'm gonna do it like that. Okay, well, place a lot of tiny elephants. Maybe I should look up the Italian word for elephant, and I'll name this zoo Tiny Elephant in Italian. Oh, petite. No, petite is French. You know what? Why don't we Google Translate this as well? Little elephant. Let's go to Italian. Piccolo elefante. I don't think that's... Piccolo is really small, is it? I don't know. Well, whatever. I mean, this looks beautiful, right? And it's gonna be like this really big Italian-like building underneath it, behind it. I really feel like it's, you know, it works out here. I'm quite proud of it. I'm just amazed by my own building. Like, I know what this zoo ends up is, and I'm just looking at it and I'm like, yeah. When I was building this, I had the idea like, you know what? I'm just gonna try it. And then I came to this point and I was like, yeah, well, this zoo is gonna be a complete and utter failure, because this looks awful. I mean, and in fair retrospect, it doesn't really look that good at the moment. I'm fully aware of that, and I don't blame you guys for saying that, because it looks pretty awful right now. And I wanted to do like this really heavily embroidered, that's a correct word? I think it is. Like this really heavily detailed zoo. So I wanted to add details to almost every single thing. And you can just see here how annoyed I was when some of the details didn't really work the way I wanted them to work. Especially with the fountain being in front of there, it didn't work, and it was so annoying. I was like, please work. Why can't I select you? This was some tiny little thing in front of there. But I feel like a lot of people must struggle with that. It's not just me. And then we use this little balustrade fancy stone thing, you know, to set it apart so you actually can't go into the fountain. And we're also gonna place a vista there, just because this fountain is so pretty and I want people to look at it. It's a little bit crooked, but you know, who cares? Reminds me of the rhyme of the crooked man. And we're gonna place some more trees, just to make it a little bit more greener. There you go, see? So much prettier. I believe, yeah, there we go, placing the vista. Perhaps we even placed some stones there, I can't really remember. It's been a while since I've built this, because I've actually finished the entire zoo already. So, over the course of the next few weeks, this zoo is gonna come out on YouTube. I feel like I could possibly do like 4 episodes and then this zoo will be done, because again, you know, it's not such a big zoo. It's fine. Here we are building this tower, which is gonna be like a passage as well to go underneath and go like into the section where the, to say it correctly, the P files will be in, and where you can also see the hippo. No, I actually quite like this. I mean, it looks pretty. It is very red next to the yellow here, but I was like, you know what? It's fine. Here we're trying to work with the terrain. I keep getting better at the terrain, I have to say that. Like in the beginning of Planet Zoo, the terrain was very difficult for me to use, and I just used an old flat zoo. All my zoos were flat. And then with the Red Tail Zoo, there was a little bit more variation where I actually landscaped before I did anything else. So, you know, that looked pretty good. And now here we are landscaping and also trying to make it look good at the same time, because, you know, I pre-landscaped it, but we are adjusting a lot of it in it. And I actually feel like it looks really good that way. And it can't be all me, that thing, so. Because I really like the way it looks. And it's very red. I'm aware of that. And it's always going to be extremely red. But I don't care. I saw this actually with a picture in some little tiny town northern Italy somewhere. I was like, you know what? I actually quite like the way this looks. So we're going to use some arches as well. You know, make it look pretty. At least I think it's pretty. And I hope you guys think so as well. And if you don't, you know what? Live and let live. My opinion, your opinion. Because I'm sure there are some things that other people build, which I'm like, yikes, did you really build that? And other people are just like, wow, this is so cool, you built this amazing. Yeah, and this is going to be yellow, and I have to be honest, at this point, I really thought McDonald's. You know, the red and yellow, and then the arches making the M, and I was like, oh my gosh, I'm building a very old-fashioned Italian-style McDonald's. What is going on? And I realized, you know what, perhaps I should just make it a little bit higher, make it a tiny little bit off red, and then put some arches around there. Perhaps that would make it look better. And luckily it did, so at least in my opinion, especially when there's a roof on there, and then once everything around there is complete, it actually looks a lot better. And I'm actually really happy with the way that it ended up looking. While I was building it, I was not happy with it. Let me just say that, because it's just like, oh no. Oh no, and then I chose this really weird yellow for the roof, and I was just like, why? And I can't really remember what roof I ended up with. Yeah, only that a taller version, yes. Now, I actually really like that roof. That roof, it looks really good to me. I'm quite proud of that. Now and then with the trims, I like it. I mean, that's just a one woman's opinion, but I actually really liked it. There. Obviously it's not done yet, it's gonna need some windows, and then the downside of that was it cast this giant shadow on the plaza, which was, you know, really annoying. I was thinking of maybe doing some stained glass windows, and I was like, you know what, who am I kidding? Let's just not do that. Because I'm not gonna have stained glass anywhere else, so why would I do it there? And you know, with the white windows, it actually looks a lot better. And then, obviously, I don't remember if we're doing that this episode or next episode. Ooh, that window was uneven. But there's... Oh, good, I fixed it. There's actually gonna be a lot of vines on there as well. And there's gonna be a exhibit there of the fire salamander, which is obviously the one that is in Europe. So unfortunately, the fire salamander is like the only exhibit animal that we have, which, you know, it's kind of bad, because I feel like in Europe we should have more exhibit animals, except for just one. Yeah, this is when I realized when I could just have a curb. So, we're not going to do the custom curb anymore. I think I cut it out. And obviously I needed a trade center, otherwise I wasn't able to buy a fire salamander. Which, you know, we bought two. And at this point, bear in mind, I had like zero, what's it called, keepers and staff and anything in there, so... Just whatever, just make this fire salamander happy. I mean, it was already pretty happy, so that's like pretty good. Look, and it's happy in its little habitat. We got a trade center. And, you know, we're just gonna build underneath here and actually feel like it looks really good. Checking out the guests that are coming. I felt so happy when the first guests were coming. I go, yes, we have a fire salamander. It's really gonna happen now. And as you can see, like right now, it doesn't look like much. I'm well aware of that. And I was like, oh, you need all these things. I'm like, no, I don't need all these things. I really don't right now. I just need to make it look pretty. And that's all I need to do. Other things I don't need to do. Obviously, I needed to put some education in it for the fire salamander. And now we are going to work on the rest of the plaza. Now, we're not going to finish the entire plaza because it's way too big for one episode. And this episode is quite long already. But here we are finishing. I think this is going to be a pizza thing and a milkshake thing. Thing shop, I mean. And in the end, we are going to add some toilets in there as well in the back. But, you know, that's for then. And not now. Right now, we're just going to worry about the roof and make sure that looks nice. There. Sometimes the roof thingies are a little bit difficult to place because they flip back whenever I place them. And that's, like, really annoying. But, you know, whatever. You can't fix everything. And there, I'm actually really happy with the way... it looks right now, and I don't know why I thought like giving it green or blue windows would be cool. It's not. So in the end we just went to dark brown, and that looked way better. You know, and on top we're gonna have like a little bit different pattern in windows. And I actually like the way that it looks. I mean, I really think it looks good. And obviously, there. We're gonna have some, terrace, I think the word is terrace, right? There were balcony back there. And we're gonna use that as well. I mean, like, poof. Like this facade walkway. And right now it's not really usable, but it will be usable in the near future. Because I decide to put actually toilets behind there, which will be, I think, in the next episode. And here we are, you know, just seeing which plants and which trees we can use there. And obviously we're going for the cypress tree, not only because it's very Italian, but also because it was one of the only trees that fit there and didn't like mask the entire building, because it's a very small tree, and that was actually really nice. You know, placing the plank. Ah yes, pizza, I was right. And milkshake, if I am correct, which I think I am. Yeah, here I'm looking for the Europe set pack, which is like the neon pizza. So I want to place it like on the thingy there. And the pizza pen. The little sign there. Yes, cosmic cow milkshake, I was correct. And I messed up the milkshake there, I was like, whoa. And then I accidentally rotated it. Yeah, I'm very good with signs, obviously, as you can see. And I believe, guys, we're almost near the end of this video. So if you liked it, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. And I will hope to see you on the next episode. And if you have any suggestions or things that you like, things you didn't like, make sure to leave them in the comments down below. And I will see you guys on the next video. Bye, guys. Have a nice day.